little bit off topic there. So we're talking about addiction guilt, right?
Yeah.
The point is this. You can't be responsible for any of this at all. You just can't. Every decision you've ever made was your response to your environment. And your environment is unique. Nobody has had your environment. Because your environment is mostly other people and that La La Land space. I mean, the only time you need to respond to the real environment is when you're crossing the road or driving a car or something. Then you have to kind of have an eye on it at least. Right. But other than that, everything else is about other people and how you are less than, not good enough, don't fit in, different to, sicker than, more broken than. So guilt is part of it. It's just not your fault. It can't possibly, who chose this? I mean, fair enough, I could be wrong, all right? Let's do a little experiment and see if I'm wrong. Just to make sure we're all on the same page.
Yeah.
You know, when you were sort of 7 or 8, you were in school, and there was that class, wasn't there, when the teacher says, what do you want to be when you grow up? Hands up anybody who says, I want to be an alcoholic, miss. I want to be a junkie, miss. Now, fair enough, if you did that, fine, I'm wrong. Otherwise, couldn't possibly have been your fault. Impossible.
Yeah.
All right. So that's an error in meaning making. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Now, your problem is once you get that, how do you explain it to them that's angry with you? Right. So how do we get past this guilt? And you have to say, yes, it was all my fault. It was not your fault at all.
Nice.
This is all my fault. I'm making amends by trying to be a better person. Okay. I'm taking responsibility. What you're actually doing is a little bit more subtle. In order for you to take responsibility for where you've got to with all your responding, you've got to start taking responsibility for that today. And the way we take responsibility for it is we admit it. I am this. I am an alcoholic. I am an addict. The I am is the most important part of that. There's a scientific basis for this, based on what we're talking about downstairs in relational frame theory. The deictic I am is your only point of power and choice. Right? If it's something I've got, you are powerless. Because you have no, how do you control that then? You have zero control over something you've got. So I suffer from a thing called depression. You have no control and you'll never solve that problem because it's a made up error in your mind that it's a thing and it isn't you. Whereas if you say, I'm a miserable git and you just be a miserable git that you are, you haven't actually got a problem anymore. Do you understand?
Yeah.
So this I here and now framing of your life is more effective for you. It's where the power is. Them there and then just get you messed up. And them there and then can be a condition that you've named. Right? So the I am, here and now I am, is the only point of power linguistically that you can take. And anything other than I here and now is beyond your control. And you're in conflict with all that stuff. Okay, so one of the things we want to do is process which is I here and now and which is them there and then.
Right, okay.
Yeah? So I here and now is, yeah, I am an addict, an alcoholic, which is why I did all that damage and suffered so much.